Hi there. In this video, we will continue our discussion on array methods. The next array method that we are going to cover is going to be the entries method. So let's start. All right. So let's understand the syntax of the entries method. So entries with parentheses is an array method. And the syntax that is used is array, whatever the array is, the array name basically, and dot entries, and then attach parentheses, and then the method will work. What it does is it returns an array iterator object with key value pairs. So the new iteration object will contain an array with index as the key and item value as the new value. This does not modify the existing array. So this is a bit confusing. Let me just explain to you what's going to happen. So over here, I have my index.html, and actually this is not necessary. So I've created an array called movies array. So you see Star Wars, Avengers, Justice League, War of the Worlds, Jumanji 2. Now, as I mentioned again, later when we're going to use the method entries over here, we're going to create a new object called new object. And I will show you that by using this method, it doesn't mutate the original array. So the original array is basically containing the movie name Star Wars, Avengers, Justice League, War of the Worlds. Okay, so I'm just going to refresh this, and over here you can see on the console. So you can see an array with a total of 5 items with index 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, now in the absence of entries method, if I were to basically display each item in the movies array, so I've created a quick function over here. So I have a button type submit, and there's a function on click display. And this basically, when you click on this, it calls this display method, display function. And what it will do is for each movie within the array, it will display the list of movies. Okay. So I'm going to click on this. So first there's this sanity check, which is working. And then you see over here. So now you see movies array by itself returns just the movie names, but without a index there, which you can see on the console. So you see 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is where the entries method is useful. So I'm just going to uncomment this out. So what I've done is now movies array. So as I mentioned, the syntax is array name. So movies array, which is the array name, dot entries. This creates a new object, which is an iterator object. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to replace this. What I want each movie, and this could be basically even I, but just to make it readable, each movie within the new object. Okay. I want document get element by ID. So this ID will display in HTML each movie, which is now in this new object. So earlier, this was what we got for movies array. Now I'm going to refresh this. Okay. And I'm going to click get movie list. So the sanity test is working alert. And you see over here. So you see the difference. Earlier, when movies array was being displayed from the function method, so you only got the name of the movies. But with this new entries method, you get a new object which contains an iterator which has the key. The key is the index value. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, these are the index values. The index is the keys, and the values coming again at the side. Okay. So this is what the entries method does in a nutshell. So I hope you found this useful, and please do click subscribe or hit the like button if you found this video useful. Thanks a lot for watching. Have a nice day.